Soon, the Bentonville School Board will discuss expanding protection to prevent discrimination based on sexual orientation. And joining us now, a board member who proposed that idea, Mr. Grant Lytle. Now, you're an attorney by practice, and one thing we were talking about before we began taping is this not only protects the employees, but it also can protect the school district.
Absolutely. Federal employees are protected, but in general, Title VII of the 64 Civil Rights Act does create causes of action for discrimination based on harassment. And harassment could be in the form of a teacher who's subject to persistent adverse comments and things like that based upon their sexual preference. And if you don't have a policy that prohibits discrimination based on sexual orientation, you cannot defend that case.
Some people would say, you know, there hasn't been any record of any issues in the past, so why try and fix something that's not broken?
Well, and I would say I have an email that we received from a very courageous teacher, and she actually used her name. I redacted it because I out of courtesy, but she indicated that, let me quote it, she indicated that, "We do believe it would be unprofessional for anyone to discuss the personal details of their private life in the classroom, regardless of sexual orientation, but there is definitely an atmosphere of fear and secrecy which heterosexuals do not experience."
So this would not make it okay for a teacher to discuss their sexual preference with students?
Any more than it's not okay to talk about your straight sex life but the teacher shouldn't be concerned that if a student finds out that she has a partner that happens to be the same sex, that her job might be at risk.
How would, I don't know, and I really don't know because I can't see that other side as far as how this would impinge on religious, you know, religious freedom concerns.
A lot of it is they feel like if their children are in an environment where homosexuality is accepted, that's unacceptable. I would say 40 years ago there would have been people who would have said it's unacceptable for my child to go to school with African American kids, and obviously we had a governor in this state that took that position.
Mm-hmm.
Interracial marriage was illegal in this country in many states until 1967, and it wasn't until 2000 that the last state repealed that law. Mm-hmm. So I can't rationalize discrimination.
Thank you.
All right, Grant Lytle, thank you so much for being with us.
All right, thanks.